Majesty is above earth and heaven. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Jesus said to his disciples, I have much more to tell you, but you cannot bear it now. But when he comes, the Spirit of truth, he will guide you to all truth. He will not speak on his own, but he will speak what he hears, and will declare to you the things that are coming. He will glorify me, because he will take it from what is mine and declare it to you. Everything that the Father has is mine. For this reason, I told you that he will take it from what is mine and declare it to you. The Gospel of the Lord. A reflection for us this morning. We take this from the first reading, Acts of the Apostles. And today, Paul is in Athens, one of the great cities, preaching about the risen Lord. In his preaching, he is meeting the people. He comes across these people worshipping gods, different gods, and they are building altars for these gods whom they are worshipping. But they had one altar of the unknown God. And Paul asks them, do you know this God who is unknown? And they said, we don't know. That's why we are building this altar for the unknown God. We don't know him, but we are worshiping him. And Paul says, this is the God of whom I'm preaching. This is the God I'm talking about. I'm bringing to you, to your awareness, to your knowledge, the unknown God whom you have been worshiping all along. And this unknown God is the God who raised his son, Jesus Christ, from the dead. He is a true God whom from now on you should worship. And stop worshiping the false gods. Many people were converted. Many people left worshiping false gods and now worshiping a true God. And Paul was able to speak to them so boldly because of what Jesus says in the Gospel today. The Spirit of the Lord will be with you. The Spirit of the Lord will teach and remind you of all that I taught you. The Spirit of the Lord will give you the strength you need. And so we see this happening in Paul. Paul, full of the Holy Spirit, he goes out and continues to preach about the resurrection of the Lord, preaching about the good news. Here we are, brothers and sisters, in the 21st century. And we may ask ourselves, are there people who are worshipping false gods? The answer is yes. Is it that they don't know the true God? Could it be yes and no? Who will make them to know the true God? Paul played his part those days. It's me, it's you today. We have to teach the people worshipping a true God. The God of our ancestors, God of our Lord Jesus Christ, a true and living God. And we can do that because we have received the same Holy Spirit who will give us the grace and the strength and the courage to proclaim the good news. And so, let us continue to thank the Lord for the gift of the Spirit has given us, the Spirit of courage, the Spirit of wisdom. With the confidence in the Father and the trust in His goodness, we offer our prayers for the Holy Church and for the world.
That the Church may be aided by the Spirit in her proclamation of the good news throughout the world in every language and culture. Let us pray to the Lord. But though that all who do not believe in Christ may have their hearts open to the truth proclaimed by missionaries and preachers, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who are
heritage of the cross, and by the commending himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the altar, and the lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, proclaiming the Paschal joy, every land, every people exhausted in praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they are praying. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the Father of all holiness. Make it holy, therefore, this begins to be said. By sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time of the betrayal and the end of the willing of his passion, he took bread and gave him thanks and broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more gave him thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in the memory of me. The mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of the death and the resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. Give them thanks that we have come here as worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray. That the partaking of the blood and the blood of Christ may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. sia caduta tu de su momento de sedio sacramenta de cama tres espiritual de tu maipa. Ambresa silipi ora de bea, caminante mai set foli tu iu. Ne va pomete miei che se parete de foli iu. Let us pray. Precious Lady, present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and believe those who have been endued with the heavenly mysteries, to pass it from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord. Prayer to combat the corona pandemic. Most merciful and trial God, we come to you in our weakness. We come to you in our fear. We come to you with the trust, for you alone our God. We place before you the disease present in our world. We turn to you in our time of need. Bring wisdom to doctors. Give understanding to scientists. And now we are given the compassion and generosity. Bring healing to those who are ill. Protect those at most at risk. Give comfort to those who have lost their loved one. Welcome those who have died into eternal home. Stabilize our communities. Unite us in our compassion. Remove all fear from our hearts. Fill us with the confidence in your care. Jesus, I trust in you. Jesus, I trust in you. Jesus, I trust in you. Amen. The Lord be with you. May the Lord.